Hypothesis testing for a population mean, part one. We will begin with the six steps for any hypothesis testing. Step number one, you state the null, and this will always have an equal to sign. Next, you state the alternative, and this will have a less than, a greater than, or a not equal to sign. And finally, you state the tail. A left tail, a right tail, or a two tail. Step number two, you state the predetermined significance level, alpha. Now, this will almost always be stated in the problem, and if not, the default alpha level is 0.05. Step number three, you compute the test statistic. Number four, you find the probability value, which is called the p-value, that corresponds to that test statistic. Step number five, you determine what the p-value indicates. So if the p-value is greater than alpha, you do not reject the null, or another way of saying that is you fail to reject the null. If the p-value is less than or equal to alpha, then you reject the null and conclude the alternative. So if you remember our saying, if the p-value is low, H of O must go. So if the p-value is less than alpha, is low, this is when you reject the null. H of O must go. And step number six, you state the conclusion of the test. Now there's a couple of parts that you should include in the conclusion. You want to begin with a statement of the alpha level. What alpha level are you testing at? Next, you want to state if there is sufficient evidence or there is not sufficient evidence for the claim. If you reject the null, there is sufficient evidence for the claim. If you do not reject the null, there is not sufficient evidence for the claim. Not and not. And finally, you state the claim in terms of the problem. Let's look at an example. The mean birth weight of all babies born in 2015, the latest year that the data was available, was 3,270 grams. A random sample of 15 births to mothers who were less than 15 years of age result in a sample mean birth weight of 3,080 grams with a standard deviation of 610 grams. Now, when you're doing these hypothesis tests, the first question you want to ask yourself, is this test involving a population proportion or is it involving a population mean? Well, clearly in this case we see the word mean, so we know that this is a test involving a population mean. So the first question this asks is to conduct a hypothesis test for a population mean birth weight. We figured that out. What must be true about the population of birth weights? How do we test this? Because the sample size is less than 30, we have to assume that this sample is coming from a population that is normally distributed. The central limit theorem says that our sample size needs to be 30 or more for the sampling distribution to become normally distributed. So one way we can check that is by using a QQ plot or a probability plot, and if the plot indicates a roughly linear relationship, then that gives evidence that the sample is coming from a population that is normal. And if that's the case, a small sample size is fine. So since this involves a population mean, the steps are exactly the same as for a population proportion. Step number one, we've got the null and the alternative. Step number two, you define the alpha level. Step number three, you calculate the value of the test statistic. But since we're involving a population mean, the test statistic now is a t. So we're going to take x bar minus the assumed value of the population mean, and then we divide that by the standard error. So we need to find four numbers. We need to know what is the sample mean, what is the assumed population mean, what is the sample standard deviation, and what is the sample size. Once we have that value of the test statistic, we can compute a p-value. Now most of the time we're going to let StatCrunch compute the test statistic step 3 and also step 4. Step 5, we compare step 4 to step 2. If the p-value is big, then we do not reject the null. If the p-value is small, if it's less than or equal to alpha, then we reject the null and conclude the alternative. If we do not reject the null, there is not sufficient evidence for the claim. If we do reject the null and conclude the alternative, then we say there is sufficient evidence for the claim. So if you remember, the claim is always going to be the alternative. The null is always our assumption. And step number 6, we state the conclusion in clear English. So we always begin with the alpha level. Then we state if there is sufficient or there is not sufficient evidence for the claim. And of course, that's in terms of the problem. So back to our example. Assuming that the above requirement is satisfied, does the evidence suggest that mothers less than 15 years of age have a lower birth weight babies? Use a 0.10 level of significance. So let's identify the values that were given. The assumed population mean was 3,270. We can assume this because here it says all babies born in 2015. That's a clear indication that all or entire, we're dealing with a population. A random sample of 15, so our sample size is 15, and that produced a sample mean of 3,080 with a standard deviation, so that's our value of S, is 610. So we have the four values that we need to compute the test statistic. What are we testing? We're testing that mothers less than 15 years of age have babies that are lower weight than the typical babies. And our alpha level is 0.10. So let's begin. Step number 1, so for the null and the alternative, we have to identify what parameter we are testing. So since this is a mean, it's going to involve a mu. If it was a proportion, it would be a p. So in this case, we assume that the population mean weight is 3,270 grams. The claim, the alternative is that it's lower than that, so we say mu is less than 3,270 grams. And this is a left tail, since it's a less than. Step 2, the alpha level is 10%. Step number 3, test statistic, X bar was 3,080, mu is 3,270, standard deviation for the sample is 610, and the sample size is 15. So using the formula for the test statistic for population mean, that is our T, substituting these values in, we have this equation, computing the numerator and the denominator. We have these values, and dividing this, we get a test statistic of a negative 1.21. I highly suggest that you use StatCrunch to compute this. You can do it by hand, but I highly suggest you do this in StatCrunch. And I'm going to show you how to do that next. So here we are in StatCrunch to compute the test statistic and the p-value for this test. We go to stat, t-stats, one sample with summary. We first input the sample data. So X bar was 3,080, S was 610, sample size was 15. Now the default value for the null is 0. We need to change that to 3,280. Oops, sorry, 70. And then we need to change it to a left tail. And down here where it says optional graphs, if you click p-value plot, it will plot the p-value and the test statistic. Next, you hit compute. Now you always want to double check to make sure that this value here that's inputted in StatCrunch matches what you want to do. If you input the sample mean here, you will get a wrong value for the test statistic and the p-value. So our test statistic in this case rounded off is -1.21 and our p-value is 0.1238. If I click this icon here, it gives me the test statistic and the area to the left, since this is a left tail. So this area here in red is the p-value, 0.1238. So from StatCrunch, we see that the p-value is 0.1238. We have our test statistic, which is a -1.21. And since we're doing a left tail, this area to the left of our test statistic is the p-value, 0.1238. So step number 5, we take the p-value and we compare it to the alpha level. So we take step 4 compared to step 2, and we make this statement: because the p-value, 0.1238, is greater than alpha, which is 0.10, we do not reject HO, or we fail to reject HO. So we're done with step 5, and then we jump to step 6. Step 6 says, since I do not reject HO, there is not sufficient evidence for the claim. So we would say at the alpha equal 0.10 level of significance, there is not sufficient evidence for the claim. And the claim is that mothers who are less than 15 years of age have babies with lower birth weights than the general population. Or another way we could say that, the population mean weight of babies with mothers who are less than 15 years of age is a less than 3,270 grams. So the sample data is saying there is not sufficient evidence that the mean weight is less than 3,270 grams. Thanks for watching.